That he is. Hey, how you doing? Marmarco here. Not too long ago, a few days ago, on Halloween of this year, which is past, and well, this year's trick-or-treating has been canceled, something unexpected and unfortunate we never thought, I never thought would actually happen. Well, there have been some incidents happening about, but the one that I feel about that which topped out the most, in my personal opinion, as a fan, on Halloween of 2020, veteran actor Sir Sean Connery has passed away at the age of 90. Sean Connery has contributed so much over his entire career. His most famous contribution is that of 007 himself. He is Bond, James Bond. For six consecutive films in a row, or seven consecutive films in a row if you count the unofficial one. If only they'd done that one right, instead of that being an actual remake of Thunderball. And more so, Connery even portrayed Sir Henry Jones Sr. of Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade, and Draco from Dragonheart. Because who could ever forget his voice? Connery's final film appearance was in 2003 of the film called League of Extraordinary Gentlemen, and well, he received mixed flock reviews, and that it's enough to convince him that maybe it's time for him to finally retire and pass the torch on to new generations. Honestly, I wish he hadn't retired yet, because he could have at the very least reprised his role as Henry Jones Sr. in Indiana Jones in the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. He could have done that. Maybe that could have been his final film, and maybe he would, like, you know, go out with a bang on that, but it's okay. It's past history. But he did, before that, he did reprise his role as 007 again, one last time, though not in film, instead in a video game, the video game adaptation from Russia with Love. I didn't think he'd do it, but he did it, and after that, he passed the torch, settled down, spent all the quality time he could with his family, but little did any of us know. During his retirement, he's been battling Parkinson's disease and dementia. And so he fought as hard as he could, but eventually it took its toll on him. It's very deep. First it was Roger Moore, and now Sean Connery. That's two James Bond actors who passed away. Now we have four James Bond actors still alive in total. One is George Lazenby, who did once, and then Timothy Dalton, who did it twice, and then Pierce Brosnan, who did it four times, and then Daniel Craig, our most current one, who's going to be doing his fifth one in a row. Roger Moore, even in death, still holds the record for playing James Bond in seven consecutive films in a row. Still holds the record even in death. And then Sean Connery. Played six films in total, or seven in total if you count the unofficial film, but yeah. I say the most roles that I feel in my personal opinion are well known. In this contribution are not only James Bond, but also Henry Jones Sr. for Indiana Jones and Draco from Dragonheart. Yeah. And my friend Johnny Vivala and I talked about it, and, well, Johnny, if you're watching this, I'm sorry if I have to tell them, but okay, Johnny decided that I should do a tribute video, which I'm doing right now, to give my personal thoughts and opinions about what I think about Sir Sean Connery. His most greatest contribution is 007, of course, because without him, we wouldn't have James Bond as it is right now, because changed the game. And after that, he played Henry Jones Sr. in Indiana Jones. Sometimes I wish he could have reprised his role for the second time in the fourth Indiana Jones film. Maybe he would like retire with a bang out on that one, or so long. But nothing we could do. It's bad. Nothing we could do to change that past history. Sir Sean Connery has dedicated a lot to Hollywood throughout the decades of the 20th and 21st century. So long. He has portrayed knights, detectives, and captains. Speaking of knights, besides playing Dragonheart, you know, as the Dragon Draco, he portrayed as King Arthur in The First Knight. As King Arthur, but in their version, it has nothing to do with magic or dragons or whatever, just solely modern and ancient modern past. He's a good King Arthur, I'll give him that. Anyway, Johnny, if you're watching, I'm sorry if I have to tell him the other part. Johnny has decided to do a sort of stop-motion project in honor of Sir Sean Connery. How? He is going to try to... I believe I remember him telling me that he is going to try to make a anime clay stop-motion video of Dragonheart, where he, you know, Draco there. Yeah. Johnny, if you're watching this, I'm sorry if I had to spoil the surprise, but couldn't help it. I didn't tell. That's all I have to say. I don't know what else to say, but yeah, Sean Connery has paved the way to future to many future actors to come for 007. Him being the first, second being George Lazenby, who did it once, but it's still historical. And the third being Roger Moore, who's most hilarious. The other being Timothy Dalton did it twice. The next being Pierce Brosnan, who was at the time my childhood generation Bond, who I grew up with and get to know with. And most current one, Daniel Craig, who completely changed the franchise as we see it. Like, changed around, go back how he started. That's very deep. You know, even though Roger Moore's version of James Bond introduced me to this series as a whole, to be honest, we owe everything to Sir Sean Connery. His contribution in order to completely create 007 franchise, you know, James Bond, and his many contributions of other films, including The Untouchables. I almost forgot about that one. Seen The Untouchables, you know, is, you know, about Al Capone taking him down. But yeah, and our hearts go out to. My heart also goes out to Sir Sean's family, who stood by with him, taking care of him ever since his secret long battle, and his personal battle of Parkinson's and dementia. He fought as hard as he can fight, but sadly, whether we like it or not, any or all good things must come to an end. Oh. I think I'll put think I'll put on some background music. That'll do. The background music that I'm playing is not actually from the Sean Connery era, it's from the Daniel Craig era. So, which song is it? It is actually a canceled version of the song for Quantum of Solace. That one's played by none other than the great Shirley Bassey, who paved the way for all Bond singers to come. She did Goldfinger, Diamonds Are Forever, and Moonraker. This one's called No Good About Goodbye because, man, if they had chosen that song, this would have been a fourth Bond song in a row. But even though it wasn't selected, we can still hear it. I thought it's got meaning to it. So, this is what I'm gonna do. When the next James Bond movie, No Time to Die, comes out, I am watching it. I am watching it in honor of Sir Sean Connery. And it's said to be Daniel Craig's final appearance as a James Bond, but I'm doing it not in honor of the great veteran actor who started the franchise as a whole in the first place. So Sean Connery, we thank you, sir, very much for your whole career and contribution of your career of acting. Especially your contribution creating James Bond as a whole into a franchise. In as the series in the first place. I'm sorry. Sorry, I don't know. I'm sometimes terrible with putting together speech. And we also like to thank you for your contribution playing Draco from Dragonheart, Henry Jones Sr. from Indiana Jones, Sam Malone, The Untouchables, and this is the only memorable. Oh, and King Arthur from the First Knight. Don't forget about that one. That's all I can remember. And our hearts goes out to his family and friends who knew him the most, and are near and dear to him. So Sean Connery, you may no longer be with us, but you will be remembered for all time to come. Through your great many years of contribution to acting, and your legacy will be remembered for all time. You may rest, Sir Sean. Rest well. Alright. Okay, Johnny, if you're watching this, can't wait to see your tribute video of Sir Sean Connery's portrayal of Draco in the stop motion animated clay. I'm sorry if I had to spoil that to anybody, but couldn't help it. Thought I might want to keep them posted for what you told me, so. I can't wait to see can't wait to see what your stop motion video on Dragonheart looks like, so could be tributing. Well, I think that's all I would have to say. I think that's all I have to say now, so don't forget to subscribe for more content. And comment down below, thumbs up, thumbs down, the usual. And also, before I go, you should know that sometime this week I'm going to be upgrading to a new cell phone. So the phone I'm going to be using, I'm going to put it away because I'm going to upgrade to a new one. I have all my data transferred from my current one to the new one. When will it come? I don't know. So it's going to be interesting. So, well, that's all I have to say. If you'll excuse me, maybe do whatever I could, so. Okay, that's all. That's all I have to say about my thoughts and feelings on Sir Sean Connery. And there was a great many contributions in film and TV, and especially the legacies of which he left behind paved the way for a great many future generations of actors to come. And he is influential. Very greatly influential. Okay, gotta go. And everybody, see you next time. Until then, stay safe, stay indoors. Always stay close to your friends and families if you share the same house. Right? Because I want to make it through. Okay, I'm out and take care.